Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 4-89 that is taken from chapter number 4, Axial Load, and the book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler. And this comes under the topic of stress concentration. So statement of problem is the steel bar has dimension shown. Determine the maximum axial force P that can be applied so as not to exceed allowable tensile stress of 150 MPa. So you can see this is steel bar. All the dimensions are shown and it is subjected to a load of P and the allowable stress in tension is 150 MPa. There is a hole of diameter 24 mm and a fillet radius of 15 mm. This height is given as 60 mm, the thickness is 20 mm and the height this portion is 30 mm. So this due to this hole and due to this fillet, there will be a stress concentration and there that will be the maximum stresses generated at these regions. So we will find the maximum load that can be applied on this load. So we know that allowable stress or maximum stress is equal to stress concentration factor into sigma average. So we'll find the stress concentration factor K for fillet. So first we will write for fillet. So for fillet, we will find K. So from this graph, you can see you will need W by H value and R by H value. So I will write W by H and R by H. What is W? So from this graph, you can see from this figure, you can see W. And W is the height of this bar. Clear? Maximum height, and that is 60. What is H? So you can see H is the smallest height, which is this one. Clear? And this smallest height is 30. So 60 divided by 30 will give you 2. Now we will calculate R by H. R is the fillet radius, which is R is 15. So 15 divided by height is the height is the minimum height of this bar, which is 30. So R by 15 by 30, which will give you 0.5. Now you have W by H and R by H. So R by H is 0.5. So you can see this is the 0.5. If I draw a vertical line from this point, and that will intersect this W by H2 graph, which is this one, this graph. And if I draw a horizontal line from this intersection point, so you will get K is equal to 1.4. Now you have allowable stress is equal to K into sigma average. So allowable stress is 150 MPa. So 150 into 10 to the power 6 Pascal is equal to K, which is 1.4. And average stress is P divided by this cross-sectional area, and this cross-sectional area, you can see this is 30 by 20 millimeter. So 30 is 0.03 meter and 20 is 0.02 meter. Clear? So from here you can calculate this P, and this P will be equal to 150 into 10 to the power 6 multiply by 0.03 multiply by 0.02 divide by 1.4. So when you calculate P, that will come out to be 64.3 kilonewton. And this is the load that can be applied or that will be generated due to this fillet. Now we will apply it for, we'll find this P for hole. So for hole, again, you have to, you know that allowable or maximum stress is equal to K into sigma average. So first we will find this K. How you will find this K? So you will use this graph because there is a hole in this bar. So what we will do is that we will find 2R by W. So what is 2R? 2R is diameter of hole and W is the width of larger bar. So diameter of hole is 24 and 60 is the maximum width. So 24 over 60 millimeter. So that will give you 0.4. Locate this 0.4. You can see this is 0.4. And if I draw a vertical line, that will cut this graph at this point. So if you take horizontal line from this point, so you will get k is equal to 2.2. Now what is the average stress? So average stress is equal to P divided by A. So P is not known. So P divided by this, there is a hole. So what will be the cross-sectional area? So the cross-sectional area, it will be this one. This 60 minus diameter of hole into this width thickness 20. So I will write it 60, which is 0.06 minus diameter of hole, which is 0.024 into thickness is 0.02. Clear? So put it in this formula, allowable stress is K into sigma average. So allowable stress is 150 megapascal is equal to K, which is 2.2, and average stress is P into 0.06 minus 0.024 into 0.02. Clear? So we need this P. So P will be equal to 150 into 10 to the power 6 divided by 2.2 multiply by 0.06 minus 0.024 into 0.02. So when you calculate, you will get P will be equal to 49.1 kilonewton. So this is the P load, that is maximum P load that is generated due to this hole. Now we have two value, one is due to fillet and another one is due to this hole. So what we will choose? So choose the maximum load, choose maximum P is equal to 49.1. We will choose the smallest between these two. Why? Because it will be the safer, and it is the maximum load that can be applied to this system. And that was all about this problem 4-89. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Also share my videos in your communities and help me in growing my channel further. Thank you for watching.